let me get to the place. And it really is hard to get around here. So we're up here on the hills around 4,000 meters above sea level, traveling through the highlands of Peru. And in search for Haplotremus species and some Bistriopelma species. What the difference between these two actually is, we'll cover in a few minutes or maybe in the next episode, because that is the glory of these episodes. We never know actually what will happen during the day.
For many years, we have asked ourselves, what is the actual limit for tarantulas? Like, at what kind of cold temperatures can they survive? And how high up in the mountains can they live? It was time to find out by ourselves, and therefore we flew to Peru this autumn to learn more. We landed in Lima, right next to the sea, and took our second flight to the city of Cusco, which is over 3,500 meters above sea level. That's like 11,400 feet in altitude. The first days were extreme, but we couldn't take the time to sit still. We wanted to see our first Peruvian tarantula in the highlands. So we started our trip, got our rental car, and drove up the very first hill we could find. And so our first hike began, easily 10 miles in the first few hours, and the headache kicked in. But we knew there are tarantulas present. There were scientific publications regarding these high altitude Andean tarantulas. We just needed to find them. The most recent ones from 2018 and 2021, where various researchers have revised the genus Haplotremus and described 7, and more recently 4, new species as well. Regarding this very first tarantula species we found on our trip, we have no idea what it could be. It's potentially Haplotremus cadercai. Both are valid candidates because of the locality. As with other species of this genus, we found this one under a big rock right next to some spinifex grass. The temperatures, as always, were like 8 to 10 degrees Celsius in the morning, and it truly warmed up during midday, but underneath rocks it was still around 11 to 12 degrees Celsius, which is around 53 degrees Fahrenheit. Our first night in the highlands of Peru, we headed towards lower levels of altitude over a period of 2 days, just to make sure that we have enough energy for the upcoming weeks and don't get fully paralyzed due to the low oxygen and headache problems. So it's descending time, but not before going up the hills one more time, and of course we needed to turn some rocks.
Good morning, starting the day, it's around 9 a.m. and this is our first stop here in the high altitude region of Peru itself. We are around 4,200 meters above sea level, and in this area we're going to turn some rocks. It is one of many stops on our way to the lowland area of Puerto Maldonados, and nevertheless, it's always worth investing 10-15 minutes and searching for some tarantulas. What is funny though is that even though it is quite high up and we only have around 18 degrees now at 9 a.m. Underneath rocks it's probably a lot cooler, and we brought some temperature measurement instruments with us, and hopefully we'll get some temperatures as soon as we find some of the first tarantulas. So enough talking. It is amazingly high up, and we have just found another Haplotremus species. So let me get to the place and then we'll have a talk. We did find two specimens of Haplotremus. We're not so sure about the species yet. It could be either Vilcanato or Carabaya, but we'll check once we're back in the car. Nevertheless, extremely nice start on the second day. And yeah, we'll give you some brief impressions on where this tarantula actually lives in this environment. You see, there is still man-made stuff going on. Agriculture is not far away, so all these trees behind us, they are like here to be cut in the foreseen future and are not part of the wildlife which is present without human interaction. Nevertheless, you always need to find huge rocks. That's what we did encounter now. And yeah, we found an adult specimen and a juvenile specimen. Just amazing start. And that's all for it now. I hope we'll find some more. And yeah, give you guys a brief introduction on the highland teraphosid species of Peru. We are now at around 4,200 meters above sea level, and it really is hard to get around here. It's not the same as when you just walk around in your home country or at around 1,000 meters above sea level. So, cheers!
This species of Haplotremus was, during the time of filming, not known to science. At one, the locality differs from other known species from the genus, and on the other, it's also different looking. Of course, the looks don't matter much when it comes to taxonomy, but in the field this is often everything we have to ID these tarantulas without disrupting them too much. All in all, we take nothing but photographs, and that in the most calm way for the spider. But of course, we take as many pictures as possible. You never know what angle is the most important in the long run. Sometimes you see morphological features which help identify the species only later on when editing through the pictures back home, like an incrustate or swollen tibia on one of its legs, for example. The vegetation consists of sparsely scattered low shrub Peruvian feather grass of the species Stipa ichu, and this isolates the whole surrounding, including the soil where the tarantula lives in, pretty good. Like, these tarantulas inhabit large rocks of the size which are like 50 times the size of the spider itself, and this gives them a quite good isolation in these cold temperature areas. And with the combination of these low shrub bushes and feather grass around it, it isolates even more from all the wind, since there are no trees and no other elements blocking the wind. The wind itself can mean dramatic decrease in temperatures. So this feather grass and the huge rocks, of course, help the spider to have a more or less constant temperature all year round. At heart, we are tarantula enthusiasts with a passion for all kinds of arachnids and animals in general, and are therefore utterly excited when we potentially see a tarantula for the very first time, which was not known yet like at all, and potentially no one in the world has ever seen this spider. We're pretty sure that this spider has been photographed before, as there are local researchers in Peru working on these taxa, but I can assure you that on this trip we have seen tarantula species which no pictures are in public, and we know for a certain that we potentially are the very first people who have witnessed a new tarantula species in the wild for the very first time.
How well did we descend with our headache problem, and when do we actually find the third species of our Peru field trip expedition? Find out in our next episode, linked right here. And when it's not ready yet, you can just check out one of our older tarantula field trip videos linked right here. Thanks for watching and see you guys next week.